Hello, I'm Mike with this week's new and trending AI tools you cannot afford to miss. Coming up, we'll look at the new drop from Google, Antigravity, a competitor to other agentic AI coders such as Cursor. We'll also look at the brand new image generation model from Google, officially known as Gemini 3 Pro Image, but referred to as Nano Banana Pro in their marketing. There's so much to cover in this video, and if you want a full breakdown on Gemini 3, especially when it comes to vibe coding, go and watch the video I put out earlier in the week where we go into depth. In this video, we're going to play with all the new toys from Google, so let's dive in. Now you'll see Google's own Vertex AI Studio allows you to test it out, but it's rather complicated and you need a lot of code to make it work. So I've got a better solution, but I wanted to call out some of the standout features of this new image generation model. Standout features for me are better rendering of long text passages in many different languages, also the ability to make images in 4K resolution, and you'll find it also allows you, and I think this is phenomenal, to put in up to 14 input images, which can be combined into a single output image. We're going to test that all out, and let me show you the easiest method I've found so far to test this brand new image generation model from Google. And I got to say, a service called CometAPI was one of the first to actually drop this when it was released by Google the other day. And you'll see the price to make an image is insane at under 4 cents a generation. So I've signed up for account, slung in 10 bucks, and I think that's going to last me quite a while. Now, the coolest thing about CometAPI is that it integrates seamlessly with Zapier. So I've got a webhook to generate an image, and then CometAPI is in here, and it's all configured to use Gemini 3 Pro Image to create an image of whatever I input in the webhook. Now, don't worry, you don't need to copy this automation. There's a one-click link down below that will recreate it in your Zapier account. Now I'll vibe code my first app to make use of this brand new image model. Okay, look at this. So far, I've said make a tool that has a prompt bar at the top, then a beautiful selector with some well-known people from tech. It'll combine the prompt along with the selected celeb, send it off to the webhook with the prompt attached. And I've got to say, I love the way that Midjourney's website looks. So I'm actually going to take a screenshot of this as inspiration. I'll attach that to my prompt. I'll say make it look like the screenshot. I'll say don't add images yet. We'll add that later. And we'll start the prompt. Now, it's worth to say, while this is being created inside Lovable, we can also spin up a database to store the images we generate and show them on the screen in that beautiful fashion. Okay, you can already see that it's thought it through and it's creating a Midjourney-inspired AI prompting tool with celebrity selectors. I can't wait to see the result. All right, here is the bare bones. It looks pretty good. We'll see a gallery here eventually. We've got celebrities. Let's select Elon Musk and we'll just say riding a bike in Europe. Now we'll go ahead, click generate, and we can see that it's been sent off. So now let's find new records on my webhook by Zapier. And there it is. Yes, absolutely. Riding a bike in Europe with Elon Musk right there as our prompt. Now we know this is basically working. We can get it hooked into a database and have it show up in our Lovable vibe coded app. Just a couple of prompts and we'll have something working. Okay, so over here in Lovable, I'm going to click the cloud button and I'm going to go ahead and connect an already existing Supabase project, which I've labeled Banana Time. And now we can see my Supabase is connected. This is like a database where I can store all the generated images and show them in my app. To get this fully working, I've said make a table in my database that can store the original text prompt and the base 64 generated string. Let's send that off. Now, while that's building, why am I doing that? Gemini 3 Pro Image actually gives you base 64 generated strings of letters rather than an image file. So we'll store that in the database and have our app convert that into an image. Okay, you'll see it's already asking me to allow, so let's do that. And if we go to the table editor over here, we'll already see a generated images table has been created with ID, prompt, celebrity name, generated image, and a created at timestamp. So let's complete this zap. Now I've got the original prompt of Elon riding a bike in Europe. We'll continue onto the CometAPI that I have already hooked up to my account. The action event is generate an AI response, and it's configured with Gemini 3 Pro Image, create an image of, and then my prompt. And we've got a very short system prompt as well, saying you're an expert image generation AI, creating high quality images. Let's continue, and we'll actually go ahead and test this step. This takes only a few seconds. It's really fast. And here we go. We can see the CometAPI has generated this big string. Don't worry about that. That's our base 64. We're going to put that in the database and have that show up in our app. So one more step needed here. We're going to send it to Postgres, which is compatible with Supabase, where we created Banana Time. We'll create a new row, we'll connect a new account, and we're good. So we'll go on to the table, which is of course going to be generated images. Now the generated image will map in from our response here in the CometAPI, and we'll also add in the prompt here, and that comes in from the webhook, and that is right here. With this done, we can go ahead and test the step. All right, fantastic. We can see the prompt, the celebrity name, and that big string, which is the generated image, has been inserted into my database. But if we refresh the Lovable app, we can't see Elon yet. One more prompt and we should be there. And we'll keep this one super simple. Show the images from the generated images table in the gallery. We'll let Lovable go ahead and think it over. In fact, it's already done and it's working on helping to display those images. All right, look at this. Over the cobbled streets of what looks like Italy, we've got Elon on his bike. Let's have some fun with this. Bill Gates wearing a rainbow face mask. Yep, that'll do. Steve Jobs eating sushi. That's a class act right there. Jeff Bezos sweating and hacking his way through the Amazon rainforest with a machete. Okay, yeah, that definitely works. That's Jeff hacking his way through the Amazon. Mark Zuckerberg with a single banana on a plate and crying. Yeah, poor. Poor Mark. That's really impressive, right? So one thing about the new Nano Banana model is we can generate realistic pictures of celebrities with just a single prompt. Go and have fun. Try this combo out for yourself. Let me know how you get on. And if you like what you see so far, throw a like and subscribe. I do videos like this weekly. Okay, so far we've looked at the new Gemini 3 Pro image. We've looked at the CometAPI for getting easy access. And now the big one of the week, Google Antigravity. Now is the time to see if I can leave all my other AI coding apps behind. Now it's time to put this to the test. I'm going to start fresh. Dark theme suits me. We'll stick with the default agent-assisted development. All the defaults here. Sign in with my Google account. Okay, and we're in. First thing you're going to notice over here with the agent is we are using Gemini 3 Pro High. I'll go ahead, open a folder, anti-gravity test, and of course, trust the authors. Now, it does feel very like VS Code. It's some kind of fork, obviously. Very similar to Cursor, Windsurf, and other IDEs with AI powers that you might have used before. I've said create me a fashion app allows the user to upload an image of themselves and 10 image URLs. You'll pass those to Gemini 3 Pro Image and create 10 different looks with different combos of the clothing items uploaded. Then I'll also say here are the docs and we'll paste in all the docs to use this brand new image model. All right, with that done, let's send this and see exactly what Gemini 3 Pro can whip up for me. First of all, it starts off by thinking about what it's going to do, and it's going through, examining the current state. It should find there's absolutely nothing there. Now, we can see there is an artifact. Now, what are artifacts? Artifacts are markdown files that anti-gravity creates as it's going along. And as you can see here, you can actually place comments on these artifacts if needed. You'll see this comment icon pops up. So I can comment on any of the to-do list that Gemini's created. So it's going to initialize a project, set up the API keys. This is all good stuff. A backend, a frontend, user image upload. This is very, very nice. Verify and polish. I really love the way anti-gravity is doing this. You'll see it's actually proceeding with the implementation plan and it's getting ahead and coding things. Now we can actually see the artifacts by clicking here. So not only have we got a task, but we've got this whole implementation plan here that I have to say looks really, really good. Okay, you can see it's running something in a terminal right now. It's starting the Next.js project and it's actually ticked this off as in progress. Again, while it's coding away, it's worth to say I'm using Gemini 3 Pro Image via the CometAPI. Documentation is really comprehensive. It also tells you how to do image-to-image stuff, where you can put in multiple images just like this and have it come out in a combined image just like this one right here. Okay, now we start to see the project initialized over here in the File Explorer. This is now completed in the terminal and more stuff is being written. I have to say, anti-gravity is really fast. Now, as you can see, it's going ahead, updating things, running stuff in terminal, keeping a track on the task markdown file. I really love the way it's going through and ticking things off as it's done in a file that's available for me to see. This is all getting created and it's configuring things. An important thing to say is this is hands-off. I don't have to confirm or touch anything. Anti-gravity is doing it for me. And we can see it actually seems to have finished. It's created another artifact. I'm loving these artifacts where it walks me through this app, how exactly it works, how to run it, how to access it, all super, super easy. So nothing is lost. And where this differs from Cursor or any other AI editor is I have that saved into an easy-to-access file or artifact, if you like, rather than having it as the prompt response, which I might lose in the future. Okay, I'm accepting all, and I actually need to create an env.local file with my CometAPI key. Let's do that. And now let's tell Antigravity, run the app and test it. So this is where I'm hoping it will make use of its own built-in web browser. So we can see it's already developing a test case, and it's also starting a dev server right now, and it's actually using its own AI to generate headshots and images that it can test with. Now, it's actually launched its own version of Chrome, and it needs to bring in Antigravity to the browser by installing a Chrome extension. And with that done, it's actually loading up my site. You can see it's surrounded in blue, meaning that the AI agent is controlling the browser. We can already see some errors, so I'm hoping the agent will fix them. You'll see down here, it's getting DOMs, which are certain parts of the website, and it's coordinating with the agent over here. So back and forth between Antigravity. Okay, you can see it's clicked around. It's looking at this very unstyled app so far. Look at this. This is amazing. And I will say all of this so far has come from just one single prompt to Antigravity, so it truly is agentic and working in the background for me. Okay, now we seem to be getting somewhere back and forth and this is working. Let's accept the changes. And why not give it a test? There is my photo. Let's grab some clothing items. How about we grab some jeans and pop them in there. We'll also add another item. Lighter jeans seem like a good idea too. Love these happy socks. Let's grab those. Now let's fill the rest with a few different shirts. Okay, and now it's time to test the best of Google's Antigravity with Google Gemini 3 Pro and the brand new image model from Google and see what we can come up with. I'll scroll down and click Generate 10 Looks. It's styling me. Well, you know what, try as I might, I've been working back and forth with Google Antigravity. It shows a lot of promise, but I just couldn't get the resulting images to display. So I'm back over here in Cursor using Claude Sonnet 4.5. We'll see if it can fix the issues so we can finally see some results. So despite what others are saying, perhaps Cursor is not quite cooked yet. Okay, it all seems to be up and running and fixed, hopefully. Let's test. And stand by. And wow, look at this. Look one. Hey, I'm digging that vibe. Look two. There we go. That's pretty plain and nice. Here's look three, the outdoors chilled look. Love the attention with the socks going on there as well. Loving look four. And oh, wow. Look five. I'm looking pretty chilled with those colorful socks. I think they suit me. What do you think? So there you go. That is pretty crazy. With the brand new Nano Banana 2, Nano Banana Pro, or whatever it's called, Gemini Pro 3 image, you can create amazing apps. And I think that would actually be great as a Chrome extension. That is a SaaS waiting to happen. Install the extension, click the image on the shopping website you're on, and have it literally put you as the person in the clothing. I think that would be really cool. If you develop it, make sure to let me know in the comments down below or join my community and share it with us there, even better in the product launches section. Well, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate you being there. Hope you're having fun with all the Gemini 3 launches this week. And YouTube is showing a video on your screen now. You should watch next. Thanks.